Hi there, Eric Bakker. We're coming back. We're talking about enzymes, digestive enzymes. We're going to talk about the signs and symptoms of enzyme deficiency. And how do you know you've got an enzyme problem? How do you know you haven't got an allergy problem? People get so confused so easily. I don't know why. To me, it's quite straightforward. But I suppose I like this learning this kind of stuff. Enzyme deficiency is leading towards food intolerance, okay? Food allergies are immune mediated and have nothing to do with your ability, you know, in terms of the enzyme issue. So we'll talk about that a bit later on. But the key things I see, signs and symptoms, are typically digestive discomfort, bloating, gas, pregnant belly, eating food anywhere between half an hour to 2 hours later, walking around like you've got a watermelon under your, you know, clothing, like lots of gas. Pain. Some people can actually have a lot of colicky kind of pain because of what we call incarcerated flatulence. So that means gas trapped in maximum security, can't get out. So, you know, it's going to hurt. If you keep swallowing large amounts of gas, for example, gulping it down, you know, you're going to come out that way. But if you've got stuff down there, partially digested food, and creating this poor fermentation in the small bowel, you're going to get problems. So remember, enzymes are basically like spark plugs. They initiate, I got water. Enzymes are basically things we call catalysts. They initiate a reaction. No different, I forgot to bring my matchbox upstairs when I got my water. I was going to show you guys, when you get a box of matches and you get a match and you strike it, what happens? The match magically lights up. You've got literally a reaction like that occurs between food and an enzyme. If we put the matches in the box, they're not going to do anything. We have to strike them on the side of the box to get the reaction. Foods break down and react under the dominion of the enzyme, very similar. We call that a catalyst. It accelerates the reaction, right? So if you're lacking that and you don't really produce quite sufficient enzymes, like, you know, if part of the matchstick is wet and you strike it, part will light and it'll fizzle. Have you seen that before when you light a match or part of it? Have you ever lit fireworks and it half went off? It's not fun. I used to have a lot of fun with fireworks when I was a kid. So, of course, if you've got partial digestion because not enough enzymes, a whole lot of problems happen. The food doesn't get properly broken down. Now, the degree of the symptom which is expressed depends on how much enzyme deficiency you've got. Enzymes are produced in the stomach, in the small intestine, and in different parts of the digestive tract, in the mouth, as we said, but the key areas would be mouth, stomach, and small bowel, and pancreas, of course, around that area. So depending on which area is compromised and how much enzyme you're producing or not producing will dictate the degree and nature of the symptom. So some men I see my age have got a major issue with pepsin. They're not producing enough stomach enzyme, and that can cause a lot of problems. They can cause heartburn and GERD and reflux. And of course, the doctor says, don't go to these guys. These guys are quacks. You need a PPI. We got to block that acid. So they actually, for a long time, believed that people with GERD or heartburn actually have got too much acid, when in fact they haven't got enough. Go to Google. It's all there. Dr. Jonathan Wright from Seattle discovered that many years ago, that most people who suffer from reflux, in fact, don't have enough acid rather than too much. Isn't that crazy? So the stomach one, symptom deficiency, we're looking at, it could be bloating, it could be burping, could be nausea, could be queasiness, and often reflux. With the pancreas, it's pain, it's gas, it's bloating. So these are typical things. And of course, what happens up top will just exacerbate issues that go further down. If you've got a major stomach problem, if you've got a problem with the rain falling on the mountain, there's going to be a big issue with that river flowing down to the sea, right? So if we put dams along there, PPI drugs, we're not really going to get that water flow down. We're not going to be putting all that nice water and silt down to the delta. All these people can't grow crops anymore. This is exactly what's happening now in China, in India. For thousands of years, people have had beautiful water flow coming down from the mountains that cycle, and they've been able to plant their crops. You know, generations of Egyptians lived like this. The pyramids were built around the Nile because of all the water. And now it's all gone. Dams. Think of a PPI drug like a dam. We're blocking that ability from that really to work and go further down. Medicine's great at ruining people's health long term, but they're fantastic at fixing things up short term. So think about it. If you're on medications for symptoms, to mitigate symptoms because of an enzyme deficiency, you need to see a naturopath and try and get off these drugs because you'll ruin your health. These drugs ruin health for a lot of people, millions of people worldwide. So the symptoms, gas, bloating, sensation of fullness like you swallowed a brick, crappy appetite, not wanting to eat food, or having inappropriate appetite, sometimes wanting to eat a lot of food, other times not a lot of food. If you get a lot of digestive discomfort and believe you've got an enzyme deficiency, go back to the video I talked about, you know, why you get enzyme deficiencies. I think it was the first or second one regarding the stress. The stress, I really believe, is one of the core issues that nobody talks about. It's intangible. You can't see it. Let's push it aside. It doesn't exist. It does exist. So if you've got a GI symptom, it may be an enzyme deficiency. Keep on watching. There's more to come in this series.